stuff. That's actually what I'm going to talk about. Taylor Swift, something is so like benign and innocuous as a simple pop song, it's just loaded with esoteric elements. They're really pushing on children. So, anyway, I want to talk about that. The Flat Earth Conference. Most of you, I'm sure, if you know Flat Earth at all, you've probably heard that. It was November 9th, 10th, something like that. In Raleigh, North Carolina, they had the Flat Earth Conference. And a bunch of, like, the local media players got together, and Grubbsky was there. I was actually invited to go to that at the very last minute. I didn't hear anything before that. And then, like, literally about 2 days before the week before the conference or something like that, I got a meeting about Robbie Davis, who kind of runs the thing, gave me an email, shot me an email and said, hey, can you make it? I could. I was going to Wisconsin. There's no way I was going to make it. But I would have gone. I would have happily gone to give a presentation and talk to people or whatever. But it's gotten a lot of shit on the internet, and it's from some of the major media organizations, BBC and things like that. We're going to talk about some of that. But, you know, there's been a lot of like controversy that's gone on with the Flat Earth Conference. There was a bunch of stuff before where like Mark Sargent and Patricia Steer were called out because they are sponsored by Metatron Incorporated or something like that. I don't even know. I'm not really in those circles, so I don't really follow any of that stuff. But apparently, like ODD TV heard about this and called them out and didn't go to the conference because of that or something, and I don't really know. I'm basically not in those circles. I'm really not involved in any of those circles. Most of those researchers probably, as far as I can tell, don't really want anything to do with it. Not really invited on the shows or anything like that. David Weiss invited me on his show. That was cool. I sent some money to Jaronism, and he said, hey, we should do a show sometime. Bob said we should do a show sometime. But I'm not really in those circles at all. They don't really me, which is fine, because I don't really want to be involved in the drama and bullshit that goes on the internet, and that's what I've seen a lot lately. As far as calling people out in shows, and this person is this, and this, you know, this guy's a CIA agent, and this is a disinfo person, and all that sort of stuff. To me, it's all a lot, it's just absolutely silly. Which isn't to say that you shouldn't call somebody out if they're a disinfo agent, or quote-unquote show, whatever. Of course, you should. I mean, it's important to call people out if they're being disingenuous. But I've seen that mentality plague the internet for the last, I mean, I've been on the internet doing, you know, podcasts and interviews and videos and stuff like that for 6-7 years now. And I've seen it happen continually year after year after year. And it never goes. The arguments and infighting and stuff like that, people were saying, like, I don't even have anything to say about Patricia Steer, Mark Sargent. But to be honest, I don't give a fuck. I just don't care. To me, it's just like petty shit. People were saying that Mark Sargent and Patricia Steer, they were infiltrating the Flat Earth community to make us all look like idiots or something. And I was like, okay, maybe that's true or not. Like I said, I don't really care. But you should probably do a little self-reflection and take yourself off YouTube for a little bit and stand back and realize you think the Earth is flat. Do you realize that off the little like communities and things like that that happen on the internet in the quote-unquote real world, it doesn't matter if you collude with Mark Sargent or hang out with Patricia Steer or are best buddies with Eric Dubay or what fucking ever. You look like a complete kook to most people. You get that, right? And so, you know, when people like focus so much of their attention and energy on making response videos and calling people shows and stuff like that, to me it seems like it's taking focus off what we really should be focused on. And that's the fact that, at least I can tell from my experience and my investigations, we're being lied to about the very place that we call home. That seems like